parachute open. Take your time. Our exploration of space has begun.
Mayday! Re-entry isn't nominal. I repeat, we've missed our target path. We struggled too much to recover it, to just lose
it now. We have it, we keep it. Jeb, that's a no then. A positive.
Oops, looks like we lost
transmission.
You're going to get yourself in trouble, Jeb.
We're already in trouble.
We survived the re-entry. Now we need a landing zone.
Huh. Jeb, do you see that?
It's the Manavan Mount.
Hold on!
What are you doing, Jeb?
Val, on my mark, reignite the engine. Bill, I need you to set me full manual pilot control. Bob, arm the parachute and prepare the landing gear. Val, engine!
We're not going to pass over that mountain, Jeb!
I'm trying to pass over it, Bill.
I'm trying to land on it.
Landing gear deployed.
Easy.
Prepare for touchdown.
Throttling down. Going backward. On my mark before braking. Bob.
Brake.
Lost a bit of the left wing, but the cargo should still be okay.
Curbcom, this is Jeb. We're at the bottom of the Monument Mount. We're waiting for recovery. Over.
We are now going to announce the crew of Duna 1, our first Kerbal mission to Duna. Covernauts Master Scientist Bob. Kerbonaut Chief Engineer Bill. Kerbonaut Main Pilot Valentina.
Oh, really? I'm going to be your co-pilot, Val?
I told you I was better.
And Kerbonaut Co-pilot Gerald.
What?
All Kerbonaut candidates are asked to remain silent.
What the hell do you mean? I object! How can I not be in the journey to Duna? Sorry, Gerald, but this is not fair.
Why would it be unfair, Jebediah?
Well, I am by far the best pilot here. I achieve records that no one has.
Oh yes, you are by far the best at disobeying orders. Duna missions require seriousness, attentiveness, the ability to follow rules. You have none of these skills. No, you don't have the right to go EVA in orbit of Minmus. No, you don't have the authorization to fix the engines during the descent on the moon.
You know exactly that I did these things to save the mission. I knew what I was doing. I never put anyone in danger.
Really? And what about 3 months ago, with this vertical mountain landing? I don't even know how to call that.
I knew it could be done. David, say something!
I'm sorry, Jeb. I'm not the one who finances and leads the Duna mission.
I will not let myself be judged by a political just good enough to stand behind a desk like you do. I'm on my way immediately.
Incident with the Duna 1 mission.
Another random failure?
Way worse, Jeb. They hit space debris right after their injection for Duna.
No.
They're alive, but their ship has been severely damaged, and their trajectory moved a bit.
Will they miss Duna?
Quite the opposite. They're right on it, at a very dangerous angle.
What about fuel? They can't burn back or use Duna to catapult back to Kerbin?
Yes, I don't have to tell you that the ship is planned to resupply fuel at the Duna base. They lost a lot of propellant during the impact. Bill is evaluating what's left, but it's clear that there's almost no chance for them to circularize Duna. Come with me. Private transmission with the crew, Jeb, and things are bad. Very bad. They have at best 350 meters per second of Delta V, and the ship aerodynamics are in pieces. They know there's no fix, and that the KSC may make things worse by making a wrong decision. They all agree that there's only one Kerbal that can land this thing. That's you, Jeb.
You know that Council will never approve that.
Yeah, I know. That's why I won't tell them. We could use the Kerhong launch site using the unflown SAK-2 rocket.
You know that you will lose your job for this, right?
I'd rather lose my job than my crew. We need to go as fast as possible for you to catch them. I already have a trajectory if we launch tonight. But Jeb, it's a desperate situation. You're probably going to your death.
Prepare to intercept injection.
Hold on, Jeb. It's gonna be a tough one. Don't worry, my friends. I'm on my way. David!
Can you receive me?
I read you, Jeb. I bypassed the KSC network security. No one can hear us. I can see Duna 1 ship. Doesn't look in good shape. I wouldn't dare imagine it. I'm going to warn the others of your arrival. Duna 1, this is David. Val, I think you should start a depressurization. If you wonder why, take a look out at 97 degrees port.
Jeb?
How in the world?
Jeb is here.
Good to see you guys.
I can't believe you're here, Jeb. Please, everyone, take a seat. I should have expected that by saying to David that only you could land this wreck, well, I should have known he would send you. You shouldn't have come.
Nonsense. So what's wrong with the ship?
You should ask what's still good.
Jeb! You have no authorization to be on board, and even less to make a decision.
I would love to know what you're going to do about it, Martin. Now, we have work. We'll get back to you when we find a fix.
Okay. I'm going to need everything you know to take a decision of how to proceed at this point.
Well, as you probably saw, the wings are missing, the Delta wing is half destroyed, and most of the hydraulics are dead. And the engine bay is... it's a mess, Jeb.
Okay, we still have 63 days before we reach Duna. Let's find a way. Dear friends, I need to be honest. I just simply cannot land this shuttle. It's just too damaged.
I'm sorry, Jeb. David sent you because I thought only you could find a way to land it.
Ooh, you were right, Val. Because I did find a way. You see, it's impossible to land this ship as a shuttle anymore, but we can land it as a rocket!
What?!
The aerodynamics are not recoverable. Some parts are completely destroyed or simply missing. I have to try to figure this out, and the only way I've found is to modify the rocket and make it easier to enter Duna as a semi-vertical position, and flip it to a vertical by lighting the engine as late as possible. We're going to completely change the aerodynamic shape. We'll have to repair the engine bay. Bill, we're going to access the RCS, because they will be essential for the re-entry. 51 days before we reach Duna. Let's get to work.
Thank you.
Okay, people, listen up. The Duna 1 crew need our help for some trajectories for their new plan. First, let me remind you all of the original mission. Duna 1 was supposed to reach Duna without incident on a 5-month trip. The ship would have entered Duna's atmosphere as a shuttle and controlled its descent through RCS and aerodynamics. Its lift surface would have allowed the vessel to glide in the atmosphere and give the pilot the ability to fly manually after the onboard computer conducted a fully automated re-entry. It would have landed perfectly near the base due to the extreme precision of the trajectory we had created. They were supposed to live for 65 days on the base, which we spent years building with robots to house the first Kerbals on Duna. During those 2 months, the IRSU of the base would resupply the Duna 1 ship with fuel. After multiple resupplies, the Duna 1 ship would have the necessary fuel to come back to Kerbin. On Duna, the ship would take off like a plane and climb like a rocket. After their injection into orbit, they would simply have to wait for the vessel to arrive at Kerbin. But that mission doesn't exist anymore. Since the Duna 1 ship has been hit by space debris, a new approach is required. Jeb and all the Duna 1's crew have worked hard to completely modify the Duna 1 ship, but they still need a trajectory correction to land near the base. For the re-entry itself, we can't program something from here, and with the time left, well, Jeb will have to fly it manually, helped by the best figures we can produce.
The pilots are currently reviewing it.
However, Jeb does not agree to rotate the left flap 2 degrees. He believes it's placed exactly how we need it.
After some hard working, Bob and I have everything in place. All the extra
RCS we created to give better controls for Jeb during the re-entry.
Guys, cheer up! We're going to land on Duna today!
Kerbcom, we're starting our re-entry. We'll tell you when we have landed.
Thank you.
It's just Jeb. Physics doesn't seem to apply to him.
Okay, get ready. I'm going to relight the engine and flip the rocket.